Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone.
Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, thanks for joining. My name is Caitlin and I am doing a DIY. Today it is farmhouse inspired and I'm really excited to show you how I did it. So this is a canvas that I have. I actually have four of them to create a window. So I just had them laying around my house because I am a painter. And I just had like extra canvases laying around, and I also painted some and I didn't like them. So I'm just taking the actual canvas part off of there and then leaving the wood for my window frame. So I don't actually remember what I paid for these little canvases, but if you would like to have like a cheaper budget, you can always go to Dollar Tree and get those canvases from there. They probably have a littler wood frames in the canvases, but you can try that, or you can get four picture frames from Dollar Tree as well, and that will work just as fine. I just had these, you know, around, so it was easier for me to do this. But there's a lot of venues that you can take to make a window. Like I said, you can just buy the canvas like this. I'm not actually sure how much these cost at like Walmart, but I will link it below if you want to just use a canvas like I did. So I'm just taking the canvas off of the wood on all four of them. Everything that we could have been, but now I'm going to stain the wood. I'm actually using ebony stain, so if you wanted to use the same stain, but just go ahead and stain all of it, all four of them. And you don't have to do the back if you don't want to, because it's going to be up against the wall, but I kind of did the back. So I was so excited to get this stained that I totally forgot to put something underneath these so I don't get stain on the floor. I mean, it pretty much looks like the floor, but if you don't want to get stain on your floor, just please put something underneath your project, or do it on a workspace table. I took some wood glue, and it's the Gorilla Glue. I love this glue. Go ahead and just glue all of the picture frames together so that it will stay nice and snug. go ahead and let that dry for about an hour or two. And now that I have my window frame put all together, I'm going to be working on getting these glass jars to float on the window. So I am going to be taking twine and wrapping it around and making a bow. And I took two pieces of long string and put them on the string that I had already tied around the jar so that I can tie it on the top of the window frame. So I did this with all three jars that I'm going to put on here. I just tied one side and then went ahead and tied the other side. And then, as you see in a little while, I do the same thing with the other jars. I just make sure that they're even with each other. You can do like uneven jars if you'd like. You don't have to do them straight across, but I liked it the way that it looked straight across. So I went ahead and just made them all even, but you can do like one higher, one lower, one higher, or like different heights with those. I think it looks super awesome either way. So now I'm coming in with my homemade chalk paint and painting the jars. The jars I did get from Dollar Tree. I thought they were really cute, and it says 1810 on there, so I thought that was pretty awesome. I was debating on coloring the whole thing or just that circle in the middle, and I thought it would look super unique if I just did that circle. So that's what I ended up doing. Here's where I'm just making sure that the jars are even with each other, and then I'm just going to be doing the same thing, tying them to the top of the window. And by the way, I got the greenery for a dollar at Walmart, and it came in a bundle, so I just cut it in three and put them in each jar. So this frame cost me like under $10, which is awesome, because if you saw this frame at a craft store, you would be paying like $30. So I think this is like a really good DIY to do to save you some money and add some elegance to your house. You say that you're sorry. If you wanted to add some more of a little treat, you can always put those little sparkling lights inside of the jar, and it would make it even more cute. So now I'm going to take this burlap ribbon that I got for a dollar at Target and cut it to size to make sure it fits right over the frame. And then I'm going to hot glue where the twine is so that it can hold the twine in place and also my burlap ribbon. So go ahead and just hot glue where that twine is and glue it down. And I'm taking this welcome sign that I got from Dollar Tree as well. It came in a pack of three. And I'm going to hot glue that on top of the burlap ribbon. I thought it would look so cute with the burlap ribbon on the back and make it stand out a lot more. Now just adding some finishing touches. I'm going to burn off the excess fur on the twine so that it will look a lot nicer. I always do that with my rope and my juke twine. Give my jars a little bit of a rustic feel. I did scratch off where it says since 1810. So I really love the way that this turned out. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this kind of content, please hit that subscribe button and that notification bell right next to it so you know when I upload new videos. Thanks again, guys, and I really hope you enjoyed. Bye.